In this video, we will demonstrate how to streak bacteria on LB agar plates so that the bacteria form monoclonal colonies that can be used in later experiments. Though simple in concept, the procedure that you follow can make this process go very right or very wrong. When growing bacteria from glycerol stalks or bacterial stabs, it's very important to start liquid cultures from single colonies struck on plates. Why? While the majority of bacterial cells in a stalk or stab should be genetically identical, there may be the occasional mutant hidden among the population. If you were to simply take a glob of bacteria from this mixed population and grow it in a liquid culture, one of the mutants could potentially take over the culture and affect your experiment. We solve this problem by streaking for single colonies. In this case, each individual colony is monoclonal, and the vast majority of colonies will be wild type. Starting liquid cultures from these colonies will generally lead to expected plasmid yields and more consistent results in later experiments. Before we begin, we'll need to gather the necessary materials. You will need bacterial glycerol stalk or stab with your strain of interest, LB agar plate with the appropriate antibiotic, sterile toothpicks or sterile loop, Bunsen burner or other flame, dry incubator at 30 or 37 degrees Celsius, and good sterile technique. First, we take out our LB agar plate with the appropriate antibiotic, making sure that there is no contamination on the plate and that it is dry. If the plate has condensation, you can place it next to a flame with the lid open for about 10 minutes to dry it out. Next, we take a look at our stab to make sure that there's visible bacterial growth. If nothing has grown in the stab, it's unlikely that anything will grow on the plate. Now, we take a sterile toothpick and insert it into the stab culture, dabbing at regions with bacterial growth. This could also be done with a glycerol stalk by immersing a sterile toothpick into the semi-frozen solution. Remember that you don't need a giant blob of cells. A toothpick that looks clean is likely sufficiently covered in bacteria. With the tip of the toothpick now covered in bacteria, we can begin streaking. We lower the toothpick and gently rest the point near the outside edge of the agar plate, holding the toothpick at roughly a 45 degree angle. Be sure to be very gentle and not to stab the plate with the toothpick, or you'll dig up some agar during the streaking process. We'll follow a defined set of paths for the streak, remembering to start each path with a new sterile toothpick. With the first toothpick, we gently streak back and forth across roughly one-third of the plate, taking care to avoid the edges. We then dispose of the first toothpick, turn the plate, and use a new sterile toothpick to start streaking a new path from where we left off. Again, we streak over one-third of the plate and end the path near the edge. We then repeat this process one final time with a third sterile toothpick. Although we must be careful, the whole process can be performed quite quickly. Be sure that the plate is completely dry before incubation. If the bacteria are in a liquid layer above the agar, they will diffuse around the plate and the daughter cells will form a lawn instead of a colony. Remember to place the plate upside down so that condensation doesn't drip onto the colonies and disturb them. Now that we've completed our streaks, we can close the plate and place it in the incubator overnight or for at least 12 hours. As you can see, our careful streaking has resulted in individual colonies that can be picked for a wide variety of downstream experiments. For optimal bacterial streaks with single colonies, always remember these key points. Use dry plates. Be gentle with the agar. Streak multiple paths. Use a new toothpick or sterilize your loop so that each path is fresh. And perform all work near a flame. Feel free to share your comments at the bottom of the page. If you like this video, check out our other videos at agene.org/protocols. Agene, a better way to share science.